whether a child of 11 years can be prosecuted or can be punished, or a child of 13 years or 9 years can be prosecuted? If you think no, then the answer is yes. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sapaha, and today in this particular video we are going to discuss about the criminal liability of a child. To establish a criminal liability, it is necessary that a person must understand the nature of crime, and there must be some mens rea. That means there must be some guilty mind of that particular actus reus or wrongful act. That's why in our criminal justice system, it is necessary to understand the mens rea whenever you are establishing a criminal liability. Doli incapace. This means basically a child is having an incapacity of any criminal liability. What does that mean? Basically, it means that when a person is a child, he is not having any sense of understanding what is right or what is wrong. So if a person is not able to understand the distinction between right and wrong, it means that a child is not having any criminal liability or he cannot be prosecuted. Section 82 of the Indian Penal Code clearly indicates and clearly explains that any child who is below the age of 7 years is not having any sort of criminal liability because of doli incapace. Now, doli incapace means that a child is not having a capacity to understand the difference between right and wrong because he is not having any sort of maturity. So the basic ingredient of Section 82 is, the first, the act must be done by a child. Second, that particular act must be done by the child or committed by the child who is below the age of 7 years. And third, that the child is not having sufficient understanding to make out the difference between the right and wrong. That's why he is exempted from any sort of criminal liability. And whereas if we talk about Section 83 of the Indian Penal Code, that describes about the child who is of age of between 7 to 12 years. And this section also says that there cannot be any criminal liability on the child who is between the age of 7 to 12. Now, if Section 82 is also speaking about the exemption of the criminal liability of the child, and Section 83 is also speaking about the exemption of the criminal liability of the child, the only difference is about the age. 82 is speaking or explaining about the age till 7 years, and here it is till 12 years. Then what is the difference? The difference between Section 82 and 83 is not only the age, but also because of the age, the maturity level which a child is having. Below the age of 7, it is purely doli incapace. That means a child is not having any sort of understanding to make out the difference between the right and wrong. But if we talk about the age between 7 to 12, here the child may be having a sufficient amount of maturity. And that is a thing which makes out the difference between the two sections. And that is a thing which, because of which there may be a criminal liability of a person or of a child who is between the age of 7 to 12 years. Malitya suplet aitatam. This means malice supplies the age. That means no matter a person may be a child, but he might be having some malice or he might be having a guilty mind. And that is the basic of establishing a criminal liability on any child under Section 83 of the IPC. In the case of Hira Lal versus State of Bihar 1977, it has been clearly mentioned that a child who was of 11 years and he was having a fight with another person, and he said that he is going to kill and cut that person into a small pieces because he was so much angry out of that particular small quarrel. And He not only said that, but he also did that particular act. He murdered and stabbed a number of time to that particular person. So as a result, defense in this case said that he should be exempted, or there is no criminal liability under section 83 of IPC, because that particular child is between the age of 7 and 12. But it has been stated that that particular child was having a sufficient amount of maturity, and he was understanding what he was saying, and he was also understanding which type of act he is doing, and he is deliberated with a guilty mind, that is with the combination of mens rea and actus reus, he has committed that particular crime. That's why he was convicted in that offense, and this particular case was also upheld by the Supreme Court. In 2012, Nirbhaya case shook the mind of every individual, and that was a case which forced everyone to rethink and amend criminal liability of a child. In Nirbhaya case also, there was one juvenile among the four criminals. And that particular juvenile, he was of 17 and a half years of age. That means there were only 6 months to attend the majority or to become a major. So this was considered as a leading case, and this was much talked about. Since the offense was very brutal in nature, and the person who was of 17 and a half years old, he was one of the culprit. That's why there was many discussion, and there was an amendment in the IPC also, that if any person who is even the age of 16, and if he has committed any sort of heinous crime, then depending upon the crime, the nature of crime, and the understanding of that particular accused, it will be decided by the court. It is a discretion of the court whether he should be tried in the session court or he should be sent to the juvenile court. But it depends upon the nature of the crime and the understanding of that particular person. So lastly, a quick revision, that first of all, any child is considered as incapable or totally incapacitated to understand the difference between right and wrong. So he is till the age of 7 exempted of any sort of criminal liability under section 82. Then section 83 of IPC says that no matter a child is of 7 to 12 years, he might be having some of the maturity level to understand the difference between right and wrong and the nature of crime. So he may be convicted, not always, depending upon the nature of crime and the circumstances. And between the age of 13 to 18, the child is a juvenile and he is still a minor. So after Nirbhaya case, it has been decided that if the child is of 16 years, then again, if he has committed any heinous crime, then it will be decided by the discretion of the court, depending again upon the understanding of the nature of crime and the person, whether he should be prosecuted in the session court or to the juvenile court. So there may be a criminal liability of that particular child. So in this particular video, I have tried to make you understand that whether a criminal liability could be established on a child or not, and in which age and under which circumstances a criminal liability can be established on a child, or a child can be prosecuted. So that's all about this video. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. For the detailed notes, you may visit to my website, that is lawcollegeu.com, where you will find all the legal notes, legal blog, legal news, many videos and many other things. You may also follow us on various social media platforms by the name of Law Collegeu. That is, we are having a page on LinkedIn, FB, Twitter and Instagram. So see you soon. Bye-bye.